Economic importance of pteridophytes. The economic importance of pteridophytes is not well documented because due attention has not been given towards their use in human welfare. However, there are many reports on their uses, especially as food plants, medicinal plants and horticulture plants. Some of the aspects of economic importance of pteridophytes are as pteridophytes used as food. The young leaf tips of ferns, the succinate taxis or crozes are used as vegetable. The young fronds of Amplopteris prolifera are sold in the market as dekhi saag in India and Bangladesh. The cruciers of Metischia struthii toppers as canned or frozen are served as spring vegetable in USA and Canada. Leaves of Marsilia, commonly called shushni, are used as vegetable. The rhizome of many ferns, such as pteris, rich in starch, is used as food. The cone or modified stem of isoids is used as food by pigs, ducks, and other animals. Pteridophytes used as fodder. Dry fronds of many ferns form the livestock for cattle. The quadriped lamina of Marsilia resembles a clover or trifolium, has been used as fodder for animals as a substitute for clover. Soil binding. By their growth, pteridophytes bind the soil even along hill slopes. The slope soil is protected from erosion. Scoring. Equisetum stems have been used in scoring or cleaning of utensils and polishing of metals. Equisetum species are therefore also called scoring rushes. Nitrogen fixation. Azolla is a free-floating water fern which can multiply very quickly through vegetative propagation. There are hundreds of moss-like leaves harboring live colonies of dinitrogen fixer cyanobacterium like Anabina azolae. The relationship between the alga and azolla is symbiotic, where the alga provides nitrogen to the plant. Thus, azolla in full bloom in the waterlogged rice fields may serve as a green manure. Rice farmers of our country are using azolla as biofertilizer for the better production of their crops. Pteridophytes used as indicator plants. Like angiosperms, pteridophytes are being used as indicator plants. Equisetum accumulates minerals, especially gold, in their stem. The rate of accumulation even reaches up to 4.5 ounces per ton. Equisetum may be referred to as gold indicator plants, which help in searching a region for gold or deposits. Similarly, Asplenum adulterinum is an indicator of nickel and Actinopteris australis is a cobalt indicator plant. Thus, these plants are found to be valuable in prospecting for new ore deposits. Pteridophytes used as medicine. The spores of Lycopodium have been widely used in pharmacy as protective dusting powder for tender skin and also as water repellents. The foliages of Lycopodium are used as tincture, powder, ointment and cream as a stomatic and diuretic. The foliage decoction is used in homeopathy to treat diarrhea, bladder irritability, eczema, rheumatism, constipation and inflammation of liver. Equisetum is rich in silicic acid and silicates. Potassium, aluminium and manganese, along with 15 types of flavonoid compounds, have been reported from Equisetum. The flavonoids and saponins are assumed to cause the diuretic effect. The silicon is believed to exert connective tissue strengthening and anti-arthritic action. Several ferns have been used as herbal medicine. An oil 5% plumeron and 5 to 8% phyllicic acid extracted from the rhizome of Aspidium is used as a vermifuge, especially against tapeworm. The decoction of Asplenium is used for cup and a good hair wash. The expectorant of Polypodium is used as mild laxative. While the tonic is used for dyspepsia, loss of appetite and hepatic problem. The root decoction of Osmunda regalis is used for treatment of jaundice. The ointment made from its root is used for application to wound. The extraction of Osmunda vulgaris, commonly known as green oil charity, is used as remedy for wounds. The chemically active principle Marceline, isolated from Marsilia, is found to be very effective against sedative and anti-convulsant principle. The rhizome and front bases of Dryopteris have been used to determine the origin and pathways of dispersed pathogenic insects like corn earworm. The preparation of Ophioglossum vulgatum as green oil charity is also used as remedy for worms. Pteridophytes used as horticultural plants. Many species of pteridophytes are cultivated for their aesthetic value. Many variants and cultivars of Psilotum have been brought in cultivation in nurseries and greenhouses in the nickname of whisk fern. Some epiphytic species of Lycopodium, example Lycopodium phlegmaria, Lycopodium lucidulum, are aesthetically more valued and can be grown on hanging baskets. Several species of Selezenella are used as ground cover in an undisturbed area because of their decent foliage and color. Selezenella waldenovae, Selezenella uncinata, etc. are grown in gardens for their decent blue color. Selezenella lepidophylla, Selezenella brevipteris, etc. are sold as dried under the name resurrection plants, which rejuvenate on contact with water. Several ferns such as Angiopteris, Asplenium, Meretia, Microsporium, Nephrolepis, Phymetodes, etc. have aesthetic values for their beautiful habit, graceful shape of the leaves, and beautiful soral arrangement. Thus, these characteristics make them horticulturally important plants. Pteridophytes used for various purposes. There are various applications of pteridophytes, such as the roots and stems of Osmunda are used to make beds for growing orchids. Water boiled with Lycopodium clavatum is used for dyeing the woolen clothes, which becomes blue when dipped in a bath of Brazil wood. The powder of Lycopodium is highly inflammable and is used in pyrotechny and for artificial lighting. Thus, Lycopodium powder finds its wide use in demonstration of artificial lighting on the stage because it disperses easily in the air and only a small quantity is needed to produce an explosion. Some of the pteridophytes member are considered to be the obnoxious weeds. Pteridium aquilinum is a carcinogenic plant which can rapidly invade the open forest lands, thus eliminating the other plants of the forest floor. The free-floating water fern Salvinia quickly propagates vegetatively and thus occupy the entire water surface of lakes, ponds and irrigation reservoirs, preventing free flow of water. Thanks.